here we are.
Yeah.
Iggy's Sports Bar.
It's too bad that the Lily Pad Cafe was closed, but I'm sure the tea and toast here will be just as good.
This place is on my speed walking route, but I never had the nerve to come in.
What happened? Did you go to the nerve store?
Gene, good joke.
Let's find some chairs. My dogs are barking.
I didn't know you had dogs.
Who's watching them? I hope they're being cared for.
Neil, Gene, it's a figure of speech. By dogs, I meant feet.
In that case, at my next barbecue, I'm going to serve hamburgers and hot feet.
Gene, more tasty wordplay.
Well, I've been reading a lot of Beetle Bailey.
Well, you can really tell. Excuse me, little girl. Little girl, my friend's feet are barking. Can you help us muzzle them with a seat?
Well, you guys are going to have a hard time finding a seat now that the game started.
Oh, dear. How long does the game last?
Like 4 hours.
4 hours?
Hey, Mr. Murgatroyd.
Shut up. We're trying to watch the Super Bowl.
Ah, the Super Bowl. So that explains the proud display of all the numbered shirts.
Yeah. I've never seen a Super Bowl.
Neither have I. I thought I had, but all I saw was one team of beer bottles playing another team of beer bottles.
I saw a Super Bowl once, but it was not by choice. I was in the hospital because my neighbor's cat literally got my tongue, and the man next to me wouldn't pass the remote control because he was dead.
My first Super Bowl. I'm on pins and needles.
I have to call you out on that, Neil. To me, it looks like you're on a mixture of sawdust and peanut shells.
Oh, Gene, you little funky, junky joker monkey.
Don't set me up for it if you don't want me to slam it home.
Can you guys find another place to stand?
Oh, certainly. Oh, here's a spot.
Ooh la la, great find, Glenn.
Hey, man, you're blocking the TV.
Oh, I'm sorry. Excuse me, little girl. Are you sure there aren't three seats?
Hey, why don't you sit on my face?
Oh, sorry. I guess we only need two seats now.
Excuse me, sir, is your face taken?
Yeah, it is.
Well, let me know if it opens up.
Oh, look yonder. I think I see a clearing big enough for the three of us.
People really seem to like your spot selection. Kudos, Glenton.
I never felt such support from what was initially an unsupportive group.
I'm telling you, it's Barack Obama. He's really changing things.
You know what? All this moving and talking has made my breath smell like a garbage can at a sushi restaurant.
I have some mints. I found them in my nephew's room.
Oh, the same nephew that's in jail for selling ecstasy out of plastic bags marked mints?
Yes, that's the one.
Well, I better take 20 because my mouth tastes like a shoe bottom.
Okay. Well, here's a bunch for you.
Oh, thank you.
Here, there's a bunch for you.
Oh, excellent.
Well, these are not the most flavorful mints.
Oh, well, just suck harder, Glenton. Most of the retin is in the middle.
I'm sucking as hard as I can. I better take more.
Fill our bathtubs with baby carrots and lettuce, and trust me, the bunnies will come. And then we'll take all the bunnies and form them into a bunny tower, which we will climb bunny by bunny until we get to heaven. And then I can find Jesus and ask him the question I've always wanted to ask. What's your deal? Then we'll perform for the angels, a monologue still at home.
We'll still call it the Super Bowl, but in our version of the Super Bowl, it will be pants versus skins. And by skins, I mean potato skins. And the winner will be decided by four impartial judges. Mary Lou Retton, a pile of my dirty laundry, a cutout of Mary Lou Retton, and a cutout of a pile of my dirty laundry.
And then Gene will oversee the construction of a three-story denim vagina, which a helicopter will slowly lower into the center of Times Square. Then the helicopter, which will be made of a high-quality salami, will be fed to a group of hungry orphans, and the orphans will be fed to the denim vagina.
Okay, guys, seriously, we're closed.
Little girl, you're rude. What a rude little girl.
That's America. It's a problem.